go ahead and set this condenser. I already got all my pipe ran, got it cut through the wall. This slab right here, I'm gonna have to cut. I got a stand I'm gonna put it on, and I'm gonna make sure the condenser 18 inches from each wall. So I'll probably be sitting out here somewhere. Yeah, I can start it right here. That's 18 inches. And I'm at 35. So 18 probably about right there. So I'll be sticking out probably right here, but they still give them plenty of walkway. It's not a high volume walking area, really just a mechanical room. So not too many people use it. So, like I said, got my pipe ran. Don't have my camera on me. So I'm gonna film parts of it. Like I said, got all my pipe ran on down this ductwork. Going through here. Got it tied into this air handler. So I'm gonna set the condenser, finish piping it up. This is a stand had built. We'll set it on. Ba-da-ba. All right, so I'm work on getting that little slab cut and see exactly where I'm gonna position. To get a shovel or something to get the old little roots out of there. Get it down a little lower. Good, that's my 19 inches right there. 19 inches, got it good and level. That'll be enough for me to put my stand. That should be good. I got my stand set about 18, 19 inches off this wall. Like I said, gonna have to be in the walkway a little bit to get it off this back wall. Thank you. 14 inches.
Gonna be about right there.
All right, let me put this phone down. HVAC people! Everybody
get this thing right.
Look about even. I ain't gonna be too far out there walkway. Give me a level. See if I can level it out. They have plenty of room once I set this on top of there.
And I put me some, try to put some concrete anchors in there. Make sure it don't go nowhere. All right.
All right, this sucker ain't light. I'm trying to slide up. Wish I went on angled it down, but it might, the stand might slide back a little bit. So I might have to, once I get it up there,
Measure it again, 18 inches from that wall.
Then once I tie in that copper, it'll help brace it too. Then I might cut it right here and straight down. Tie in there. All right. All right, battery kind of getting low on the phone, but I'm gonna start getting much as I can of this. Putting this copper together. But I'm start from the bottom and work my way up to the top. Put me a little elbow right there. Put an elbow right here. Like that. And then I just shoot straight up and I know exactly where to cut it. Set that right there. It probably cut out, I don't know. But with
insulation. About 20 and a half. Electrician still ain't here, so all I want to do today is leave the nitrogen charge on it. I just do a leak search, and then whenever he come and do a disconnect, I come pull it back and charge it up. I don't know how much the pressure is gonna hold. Bit. Should be perfect here though. Thank you.
probably about 75. Big cutters ain't no good. That's why I'm using big small. I bought them brand new. But the thing is stripped out of them. Take them back. Less than a month though.
Man, I wish I had my rose bud.
Broke that too. Brand new. Snapped in half. At the bottom. Pause. I need to put some on that valve, cool it off.
replace those valve stems anyway. Destroy the core. Too close. I use a lot of solder on that joint, but you want to make sure that don't leak. Alright, got that first one, like I say. For the sake of time, I'm gonna go ahead and pause the video. And start it back once I get up top. Look like I got it, but I don't like that little thing now. Alright, see now that's gonna hold it for me. I can go straight up. I got this one soldered halfway in. I'm gonna go ahead and do my liquid line. I ain't really got no plan, I'm just freestyle line how I'm tied in. I'm gonna get that liquid line out the way. I wanna weld this one up and go ahead and put my insulation. I don't wanna have to burn it. But I think I'm just gonna connect right here.
with that soft copper. Cause I ain't got no air balls, so I don't wanna do too much cutting.
So I'm gonna bring out the swedge tool and the tube bender.
About 20.
do this without cutting it off. Do another 90. See where that put me at.
Kind of hard, you ain't got about a hold it for you. I think I can give me a zip tie.
I cut that thing 6 feet.
I should have cut it about 7 feet. So now, I can tie it in right there though.
But it's all good. I can just bend this copper down into it.
So it'll work. Now I gotta come up with something to hold it. I think I got some zip tie. Well, I got some zip ties.
Let's see if I can hold it with those.
Should hold 3/8.
Got
Yeah, I got my GoPro camera in my truck, but I ain't bring no little memory card thing. It's kind of hard to do with one hand. I'm trying to film too. And it's fried, I'm trying to get out of here. But as soon as I can get it, I got a little job to run myself. And I'm gonna hit the road for the weekend. Let me see how I'm gonna do that. Boy,
right there. Anyway, I'm just gonna ream this out.
I got this one. Sort of halfway in. I'm gonna go ahead and do my liquid line. I ain't really got no plan. I'm just freestyling how I'm tied in. I wanna go and get that liquid line out the way. I wanna weld this one up and go ahead and put my insulation. I don't wanna have to burn it. But I think I'm just gonna connect right here. That soft copper. I ain't got no elbows, so I don't want to do too much cutting.
So I'm going to bring out the swedge too and the tube bender. See if I can do this.
I don't really know how I want to do it. Let me see if I can go that way a little bit.
Water 3/8.
about 20. Another 90. See where that put me at.
Kind of hard when you ain't got about to hold it for you. I think I can do, give me a zip tie.
I cut that thing 6 feet.
I should have cut it about 7 feet. So now, I can tie it in right there though.
But it's all good. I can just bend this copper
down into it. So it'll work. Now they gotta come up with something to hold it. I think I got some zip tie. Well, I got some zip ties.
Let's see if I can hold it with those. Thank you.
I got my GoPro camera in my truck, but I ain't bring no the little memory card thing. It's kind of hard to do with one hand. I'm trying to film too. And it fried, I'm trying to get out of here. But as soon as I can get it, I got a little job to run myself. And I'm gonna hit the road for the weekend. Let me see how I'm gonna do that. Boy,
right there. Anyway, I'm just gonna ream this out.
That's a wrap there. Filter in sight glass. Like I said, I'm just gonna leave it with about 175 PSI nitrogen. Nitrogen might sit in there a couple of days. Yeah, electricity probably can mount him a box right here. The disconnect. Now here's something.
That's a leak. I must miss that whole back side.
Hold it in. Got another little thing right here. I didn't see that one. Good thing to do a leak search though. You know, 100% you ain't got no leak. Had to use all my knife, man, bro. That's what it's for. About 2:49. Trying to get out of here rushing. I should have used that mirror before I even put some nitrogen in there. I already leak checked my other wells.
I honestly forgot to put the filter dryer in here. I had bought it.
I forgot to put it in there. But I had 175 PSI on the rest of the system, and it held for about an hour. At least I ran and got the filter dryer. I already had the sight glass. I just didn't have the right size filter dryer in my truck. So I just ran and got it, put both of them on real quick. I sure thought I was out of here.
Good. Somebody gonna get that little well right there. Check them all this time. Alright. That one look good. That one look good this time. That one good. That one good. I'll try this again. Hear none this
Put that rest of that bar in there. Should be about 175 to 200 PSI. I'm gonna do some house cleaning. All right, HVAC people.
you can see, I got about 180, 185. Like I say, so I'm just gonna let that hold until the electrician come out. All right.